I remember seeing Zealous for the first time and thinking to myself, I believe this watch brand will go the distance. In the very early stages of Zealous, I could already see that in a world of hundreds and thousands of watches, they still managed to have their own identity. We've reached a point where a lot of watch enthusiasts will see a Zealous and without even seeing the logo, we can tell it's a Zealous. That is part of the reason why I no longer consider this brand a micro brand. While I have been quite critical of some of the watches Zealous has produced, today's watch kind of caught me off guard. I accepted the watch to review because I've already experienced enough watches from them to know that whatever they send me to review, it's gonna be good. Keep in mind, this is not a promotion. I don't get to keep the watch. I just love sharing new watches with you guys. Zealous is a brand that I've been a fan of, so I don't mind doing the review. No compensation whatsoever. But when I got the watch in and I looked at the movement, I noticed something. I've seen this movement in sort of high horology pieces before. Maybe it was Arnold and Son, maybe it was Angelus, I don't really remember, but I could tell that this is a movement I've seen before. Then I took a look at the press kit after I got the watch in and I realized Elshon, the owner of the brand, decided to go with a Le Jeu Perret movement. Now the reason this sort of shocked me is the fact that I always associate Zealous with some phenomenal affordable watches. Using calibers such as ETA, Sellita, and Miyota calibers, which are great movements, but a Le Jeu Perret is just levels above that. So when I saw it, and keep in mind, I haven't even seen the price yet, I already know that they're dabbling in the sort of high horology luxury territory, which takes a lot of guts, especially with a smaller brand like Zealous. Now we do have to discuss the price of this piece because like you, when I first saw the press kit, I thought this watch would cost anywhere from $10,000 to let's say $12,000. But to my surprise, the titanium version you see in front of you cost about $3,900. If you want a tantalum or Damascus, you're going to pay $4,900, and a full sapphire case is going to cost you $8,900, which makes a lot of sense because a sapphire case is extremely hard to make. Just look at Richard Mille, you're going to be paying about $100,000 for one, which does make sense. But let's take a look at this specific piece, the titanium case at $3,900. Do you have any real competition? Well, you have your regular suspects. You have Omega, you have Grand Seiko, you have Tudor, but this watch has an 8-day power reserve, a beautifully finished watch. Even when I put it under macro, I was pleasantly surprised, and it has sort of a skeletonized look to it, which I can't really think of the usual suspects when it's competing with this kind of watch. Maybe you can buy a pre-owned Hublot skeleton watch, but then I'm gonna have to ask you to leave. As shallow as it may sound, it really does come down to whether or not you're comfortable buying a watch at this price from a smaller brand. Most people will be more comfortable buying from a mainstream brand, which is completely understandable, but in a world where independent watchmakers are now starting to rise, I feel more people are gonna get more comfortable, especially with the amount of value you get with this timepiece. Now, let's take a look at the technical specifications so you can see exactly what you get for your $3,900. Now this watch comes in at about 42 millimeters. To be fair, when I first got this watch in, I thought it was a 40. It does wear a lot smaller. Perhaps it has to do with the lug to lug distance, which means top to bottom of about 47 millimeters. The thickness is 13 millimeters, which is a little bit thick for a manual wind caliber, but I'm willing to forgive it for that 8-day power reserve. Finally, you get a 20mm strap size. Given the fact that this watch is a strap monster, that is actually a really good thing. Now, one thing I didn't necessarily like is the fact that this watch is in titanium. I have no problem with titanium, but I'm starting to have a preference towards stainless steel, so that is just a personal negative. If you don't mind titanium, this watch is super light. Putting it on the wrist in my 6.5-inch wrist, it is in fact very comfortable with that 47mm lug to lug and that titanium case. You're getting a great daily wear. Now the movement powering this piece is a manual wind movement with a twin barrel system. This is what they call turbine twin barrels, as you guys can see from the aesthetics, but essentially the twin barrels is the reason you're getting 8 days of power reserve. Now, of course, at $3,900, I was a bit skeptical, so I put this watch under macro, and I can tell you the Le Jeu Perret is finished to the same level of every single Le Jeu Perret movement I've ever experienced. Very luxurious, very high-end movement, impeccable finishing for what you get, especially at this price point. This is why I'm going to say, even though $3,900 is a lot of money, this watch is an absolute value. Would I personally own it? I would actually say no. And the reason is, the watch is just not my personal style. But if I was after an exceptional watch, I was after a value watch with a high-end movement, 8 days of power reserve, you're very hard-pressed to find anything that could even compete with this watch, especially at that price. My opinion, Zealous did a great job, and if you're considering this watch and this is your style, I would highly recommend it.